On November 3rd, the Knox County Board of Education approved the concept of a Science, Technology, Engineering, and Mathematics, or STEM Academy, to become part of the Knox County school system, presented by Superintendent of Schools James McIntyre. The STEM Academy would be a magnet school for the county that would focus on teaching students in the fields of science and mathematics. The school's home will be in the L&N train station building, and initial funding for the school will come as a grant from the state's Race to the Top program. Board member Cindy Buttrey pointed out that while initial costs were provided for in the grant, the costs of maintaining such a facility annually are unknown, and Superintendent McIntyre had no answer for her questions. Many in the crowd were dissatisfied with the board's 9-1 decision to approve this new school, especially the large contingent of members of the Carter community. Many in the Carter community showed up at the meeting, hoping the board would allocate funds to have a new Carter Elementary School built to replace the current structure, which was built in 1938. The County Commission removed $5 million from the board's capital improvement plan in a meeting earlier this year, and this has prevented a new school from being built in Carter. Renovations have been planned for the current Carter Elementary School building, but many in attendance felt that these measures would be inadequate.
Stipulation that all funds over and above what is already requested be paid for with Knox County debt service. A new Carter Elementary School is the right thing to do, both for the Carter community and for Knox County. Go the extra mile and ask County Commission and the Mayor's Office to see if they can find the funding without affecting Knox County School's instructional funding.
After long discussions on how to best handle the situation, the Board of Education voted to send the issue back to the County Commission. It was decided that they request the County Commission fully fund the original improvement plan by providing the board with an additional $5 million.